Hi, I'm Kevin Hogan with Rock Island Auction Company, and I'm standing here today with my friend and firearms expert, Richard Ellis. We're here today to talk to you about our upcoming September 7th, 8th, and 9th Premier Firearms Auction. We're touting this sale as our most anticipated auction in our company's history, and for good reason. The bulk of the sale is comprised of four major estate collections, all different in their scope, but share a common theme of high quality, rarity, and diversity. The first, the Gateway Collection, of rare Colt single actions, percussions, Winchesters, Smith & Wessons, and other early 18th and 19th century arms. The second, the William Ashby Collection, comprised of Derringers and early Marshall pistols. The third, the William Doc Janet Collection, of high condition, rare Civil War arms. And the Michael Barrett Collection, of 18th, 19th, and 20th century military headgear. Richard, let's talk about what we have presented before us. Just a stunning, high condition, and rare group of Winchesters.
Yeah, it's like if you had your wish list of all the neat Winchesters to own, they're before us in some manner.
It's true.
Yeah, I mean, you're talking, I see a lot of 50 Express 86s. You have deluxe 73 Winchesters with case-hardened frames. You have an engraved 73 first model carbine. You have that wonderful high wall shoots in with the, what, Dutch cheek piece?
That's right.
And so I always used to think a Swiss, you know.
It all letters.
All letters in that configuration. And then, oh, by the way.
Let's go after the elephant in the room.
Yeah. You have two very fine 1-1000 Winchesters. One to my left with that half octagon barrel. Yet it has the desirable, instead of a shotgun butt, it has a desirable crescent butt. But as I recall, of the 120 1-1000s that were made, there was less than a half dozen or?
Seven. Yeah,
seven.
Seven and half octagon, half round, five in the 24 inch, two in 26 inch, but none of them lettered with the crescent butt except this one. So even when you get down to the, you know, minutest rarities, the 1-1000s, you have variants. And both of them are presented in the collection.
As I recall, you were recently in attendance. We're promoting this collection of the Cody Show, and you stumbled into one of the 1-1000 book authors.
Yeah, the renowned author and expert, Mr. Ed Lewis, and he looked at it and he said it was a fantastic gun. And I think what brings further provenance or aura to the collection, the Gateway Collection as a whole, is its freshness, if you will. You've been around the business a long time, he's been around the business a long time, and this was unknown to him, undocumented, it's not photographed. I don't know if it has, to our knowledge, we're unaware if it's ever been offered for public sale. But, I mean, speak to the freshness of the collection.
Oh, well, that sums it up. Everybody, you know, I always get a kick out of 1-1000 Winchesters, and everybody knows everyone. You know, whether or not they owned it, they seem to identify around a 1-1000, like identifying with the blue chip.
Right.
And here's one we found that they didn't know about.
Yeah, I guess kicked out of the brush, if you will.
And ironically, to my right, is another one they didn't know anything about, and it did not come out of the Gateway Collection, but came to us as a one gun consignment as a direct result of handling this Gateway Collection. And I think it was a restaurant owner or something. I remember this gun coming in. It's interesting.
Right. It was kind of a mythical gun. It was somewhat known through whispers and stories, came from up north, and it was, sure enough, it turns up.
It was refinished back in that day, about in the 1950s, and they had it gold-plated. Originally, it was case-hardened, as I recall. But it, you know, it's still very attractive, and it, in and of itself, it's a wonderful item, you know, to have a 1-1000. It's not as valuable as this, but if you're, you know, this is $250,000 area, here is something that could be obtained in the five-digit figures, which that's what we bring to the table here at this auction, you know,
right,
in our company, is this, in my estimation, would be wonderful to own, and you can live with a refit.
Yeah, and make no bones about it, this gun, factory letters, as a 1-1000, no question about it. And let's move on to some of the other rare features on just some of the beautiful guns. This 73 is one of the personal favorites of mine sitting on the table.
Oh, yeah. It letters, as I recall, with that wind gate front sight with a spirit level. That's something you'll see on high walls. You do not see it on 73 deluxes.
Just high condition, a lot of presence. Notice just the beautiful case color, all the blue on the loading lever or loading gate. It's fantastic.
And we can bounce from that, since we're talking about sights, which are very much a part of a Winchester rifle. And I recall, didn't you say we just got the letter on this?
Yeah, we
sent sight letter, that military sight.
Sent in for a letter. I if you recall, I brought it to you and I said, Richard, do you think this will letter? You said, I don't know if it's going to letter, but it's been on its entire life. Yeah. And sure enough, it letters.
Yeah, I mean, it's wonderful. You know, it has the special features. It's a big, desirable in that 86 Winchester, which is a big cannon, in my estimation. And, half octagon, deluxe. And there again, you've got the crescent butt and the checkered wood. And what more can you ask for? It's unique. Right above it, another 73 deluxe. We're making 73s look common.
Yeah.
And we're lucky to even have one good deluxe in an auction. And here we go. We have them in quantity.
Right.
That's
right.
What this Gateway collection has afforded us. And above it, the big cannon, 50 Express.
And just a drop-dead stunning gun. I mean, if that's for the discriminating taste only, that's just a beautiful, that's as new as you could ask for, especially in a 50, right?
Right, and we have another 50, and there's something we should talk about here. What, with case hardening, when it left the finish, sometimes it's a term called silvering out, but it's attractive. Sure, this is how it started, but if one's going to be down in condition a little bit, and the case hardening, I like that. I like, there's different ways of aging.
Right.
And here we go again, another 50 Express. It's like there's a lot of 50 Expresses in this sale.
We have a few 76s. You see the 86 represented here. And really, I mean, this is just the tip of the iceberg for what this auction has to offer. We can't encourage you enough to attend live. It's the only opportunity you'll have to see this stuff with your own hands and your own eyes. We make it a fun weekend, I promise. Look forward to seeing you in September.